Grace, mercy, and peace be to you from God our Father and from our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. The basis for our meditation this morning is the gospel reading in John chapter 20. But before we even get there, I wrote as the theme for our day today, quarantines won't give you peace, but Jesus does. Quarantines can't give you peace, and they can't stop the spread of the most deadly disease, original sin, which has a death rate of 100%. Yet here we are, a week later, and fear remains. We need Jesus to give us peace. Our text from the gospel begins with the 10 disciples on lockdown. Judas had killed himself and Thomas wasn't there, so there were 10. The text begins, on the evening of that day, the first day of the week, the doors being locked where the disciples were for the fear of the Jews. The disciples of Jesus Christ were afraid to go out. They were afraid of death and punishment by the authorities. As they are in lockdown, they see someone that looks like Jesus in the house, even though the doors were locked. It is possible that another fear struck their hearts: shame. They were cowardly and abandoned their Lord. They were faithless and ran away when he was arrested and crucified. Peter had said, "Even though they all fall away, I will not." The others chimed in and agreed. If you would have had been there, you might have said the same. But where were they when the authorities came with weapons and threats of arrest and beatings? Jesus said to Peter, "Truly I tell you, this very night, before the rooster crows twice, you will deny me three times." But he said emphatically, "If I must die with you, I will not deny you." And they all said the same. You know what happened. But after Jesus rose from the dead, he did not come back to scold them. Instead, Jesus came and stood among them and said to them, "Peace be with you." They may have been at peace, physically speaking, while they were locked down in their home, but they had no peace in their hearts. Jesus doesn't wait for them to get enough courage and come out. He doesn't even knock on the door. They certainly would have been freaked out if they heard knock, knock. Instead, he goes right through the door. And with the power to comfort their hearts, he says to them, "Peace be with you." It wasn't just a ghost, but Jesus, risen with his crucified body, enters without opening the door and gives them peace. He isn't waiting for us to do something because he knows that we do not have the strength and the courage to do it. We can't even open the doors for Jesus to come in. Yet we have this comforting message in Scripture. If we are faithless, Jesus remains faithful, for he cannot deny himself. What this means is that Jesus made a promise to come and save sinners who lack faith. He doesn't die and rise for strong and holy people because we are not strong and holy in ourselves. We are doubters, like Judas, Peter, Thomas, and all those on Palm Sunday. We lose faith, but Jesus remains faithful to the promise he made, and even faithful to his name. Remember, Jesus means Savior, and that cannot be denied. The most important thing for you to remember today is that Jesus does these things for you, not for himself. He doesn't die for himself, he dies for you. And likewise, he doesn't rise for himself, he rises again for you. So back to that opening verse, when Jesus comes into the room and says, "Peace be with you," what kind of peace does Jesus give? There is a difference between earthly peace and heavenly peace. Earthly terror comes when there is a war and the enemy is at the gate of the city, or in our case, when police came with guns, jumped the fence, and stormed the mission center. At that moment, there was terror until the police left. But even after they left, you weren't really completely at peace, were you? But this is not the type of peace that Jesus gives. In fact, he even alerts us that we will not find earthly peace, but he promises a different kind of peace. He says, "Behold, the hour is coming, indeed it has come, when you will be scattered, each to his own home," kind of like a quarantine, "and will leave me alone. Yet I am not alone, for the Father is with me. I have said these things to you, that in me you may have peace. In the world you have tribulation, but take heart. I have overcome the world." We can see that Jesus was and is telling the truth. In the world we have tribulation. We suffer from poverty, corruption, tribalism, and now this pandemic. But the world is indeed infected with a more deadly virus than COVID-19. The true virus is sin, which causes all kinds of evil, hatred, and death. The church is the only one that has the medicine to cure this sin and death: the saving gospel of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. But now we have another tribulation, because the devil does not want you to receive the gospel. And this is why there's a major war going on right now. The devil is flinging all kinds of fiery darts and arrows at you. He's putting up blockades of fear so that you can't get to the true hospital, the truth, and to give the church and get that saving medicine. Jesus knows these attacks, and he comes through the door to you today and says, "Peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you. Not as the world gives do I give to you. Let not your hearts be troubled, neither let them be afraid." Jesus comes to give you peace. The world cannot give true peace, but Jesus gives it to you today. How? Because he extends peace to you. He doesn't declare war or terror. There should be war because God hates sin. But instead of destroying sinners, he destroys sin by dying for you on the cross and rising again to give you hope of life after death. He rises not as a spirit, but in flesh and blood. The second account of Jesus giving peace makes that concretely clear. In verse 26, it says, 8 days later, his disciples were inside again, and Thomas was with them. Although the doors were locked, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and and see my hands. And put your hand and place it in my side. Do not disbelieve, but believe." Thomas answered him, "My Lord and my God." When we are sick and feel the pains in our bodies, we might have doubts and disbelieve the resurrection of the body. Thomas suffered disbelief and was cured when he puts his fingers into the place where Jesus was crucified for you. Today, instead of placing your fingers into the crucified and risen Jesus, he places himself into your mouth. And his body and blood are the physical assurance that we shall rise again, because your Lord and your God are in you, and therefore you shall rise again like the dry bones. We heard the question in Ezekiel, and what did God say about that, about those dry bones rising again? Ezekiel 37, verse 3, "Son of man, can these bones live?" And I answered, "O Lord God, you know." Then he said to me, "Prophesy over these bones and say to them, 'O dry bones, hear the word of the Lord.' Thus says the Lord God to these bones, 'Behold, I will cause breath to enter you, and you shall live. I will lay sinews upon you and cause flesh to come upon you and cover you with skin and put breath in you, and you shall live, and you shall know that I am the Lord.'" Thomas answered him, "My Lord and my God." Death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is your victory? O death, where is your sting? There is no greater peace than this. The reason that the whole world is terrified is because they think that they're going to contract this disease, that they're going to get infected, and that they're all going to die. It's absolute foolish fear, because even if they develop a vaccine for coronavirus, it doesn't mean that they're going to live forever. Everyone's still going to die. Death is still there. They're not removing death. But Jesus has. What sweet words from our God when he says, "Death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is your victory? O death, where is your sting?" Why is this so great? When Jesus mocks Satan and asks, "Where is your sting?" You know what he's talking about? He's talking about a bee. He's making Satan to be like a little bumblebee. And he knows that when Satan puts his bumblebee stinger into Jesus, Jesus swallowed up by rising from the dead. And Jesus is mocking Satan because a bee only has one stinger. And once it stings someone, it's now less than a fly. Can't sting anyone else. The devil put his stinger into Jesus and swallowed it up. Death no longer has any terror over you because Jesus has the vaccine, the saving gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. The good news that even though we die, yet shall we live, because your King is the King of Kings, Jesus Christ. The peace Jesus gives us is freedom from sin, from the fear of sin and death, because Jesus swallowed it up for you. Let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, to which indeed you were called in one body. Amen. Now may the peace of God, which surpasses all human understanding, guard your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus.